Sometimes, an evidence sample might contain a large amount of material from one DNA source and only a little from another. Consider, in this display, two known samples. One is a male, shown in the top electropherogram. The fact that he is male is apparent by the two green peaks visible at the left, representing an X and a Y allele. The other known sample is a female, shown in the bottom electropherogram. Her electropherogram displays only one tall green peak at the left, representing her two X alleles. The center electropherogram is that of the evidence sample. Note that every peak in the evidence sample's electropherogram matches to a peak from the electropherogram of one of the two known samples, indicating that those individuals could not be excluded as being the two contributing sources of the DNA found in the evidence sample. Notice also that the peaks in the evidence sample's electropherogram that correspond to those from the female's electropherogram are not as tall as those that match the male. This means that more of the male's DNA than of the female's was present in the evidence sample. The male, therefore, would be referred to as the major contributor to the evidence sample, and the female would be referred to as the minor contributor.